journalists are at this event? I said, I'm the only one. I said, okay, how many Westerners are at this event? He said, you and that guy. There's two white people at this whole thing. And I said, is there anyone from the government here? He said, no. So I said, so what is this? Does this have any weight or impact whatsoever? He said, absolutely not. I'm going to go home tonight and write a big article about this like I always do. They're going to chop it down to like 200 words and bury it in the newspaper. So I said, does that lead me to believe that multinational corporation Union Carbide came to this country, set up a pesticide plant in the middle of the country, killed a bunch of people, and just laughed it off and walked away? He said, you got it. And as you know, multinational corporations do this all over the world. They let oil pipes explode in the Gulf, and they let pelicans get covered with crude oil. They destroy the ways of life of coral reefs and fishermen and people in the interior of countries as the oil comes in and destroys everything in its sight. And they disenfranchise people, treat them like slaves, put them in hot, unventilated rooms, and make them work until they pass out and die for 20 cents an hour. And I want to see this stuff as close as I can, because like I told you 3 hours ago, you can still feel your asses in your seat. I'm trying to make as much trouble as possible, asking questions, trying to see why the world still seems to work at this dysfunctional rate that it does. And so for 12 weeks, I went all over the world asking questions, sweating it out, walking down every path I could, around lakes, next to rivers, down railroad tracks, into slums, into places where people told me not to go. And I cannot overemphasize it to you that I am not brave, I'm not a tough guy, and I'm not looking for a fight, but I am insatiably curious. And I kind of hope that curiosity is my shield. Because I would walk into places where everyone would stop. And someone who knew some English would basically say, we have to live here. What are you doing here? And my stock one-liner is, my name's Henry, what's happening? And I met people all over the place, and they were heartbreakingly friendly to me. No one ran after me. No one said death to America. No one hurt me at all. In fact, people were generous. They were very friendly. They were very informative. And so for 3 months, I basically walked around the world with my camera, getting information, meeting people, interviewing people, and coming to all kinds of conclusions. Hence, when Iris Lopez says that I did something to her, I cannot indict all of humanity, having met a fair slice of humanity, and my field results come back telling me that people are okay, even in dire situations. And so eventually, I find myself, after several months of travel, on the freezing streets of Beijing, China. And I would leave my hotel in the morning and walk to Tiananmen Square in the Forbidden City, and I'd be assaulted by would-be tour guides who would walk